Today I'm going to show you how to install a leather drive belt on an antique phonograph. What you'll need: some vice grips. We're going to use them for the impression that they make in the leather belting. A brand new razor blade, your high quality cylinder phonograph leather belt, and a spot of glue. Because I don't have a machine available, what we're going to do is fit the belting onto this old tape spool. First, we're going to take our belt, wrap it around the object, and we're going to mark it with a razor blade. Actually, if you want, you can mark it or cut it. Take it from the ends, stretch it out gently. Now, where your fingers were holding the leather, that little area there won't stretch. So you're going to bring your fingertip out and just give it a little extra tug. Okay, back to our object. We're going to remeasure. And notice, just from that little bit of stretching, belt's gotten a little longer. We're going to measure right to the end, like that, and cut. Now, when the belt is in position, we're not going to glue it together like this. We're actually going to lap it over. And to do that, you're going to need your razor blade. On the top of the belt, you're going to take your razor blade, go up about a quarter of an inch, and then draw it across like that. Try to get a better edge here. So it creates a slight bevel. Now, where the belts are going to meet, notice we're going to have to do the same thing to the bottom of the opposite end. So, I like to use a block of wood or a hard working surface for doing this. We're going to do the same thing. Create a very steep angle. So now, the belts lap over like that. Depending on the machine, you may have to assemble the belt on the machine and then, after it dries, slip it over. But for this demonstration, I'm going to assemble the belt off the machine. So as you see, I put a drop of glue right there, and we're going to put the two ends of the belt together. Make sure that the belt is straight. Okay. Now what I like to do is use a vice grip and go right on that line and gently press it together. And I'm actually going to loosen the vice grip up a little bit so it's not squashing it. And then I'll go over to the other line on the back, the end of the belt, and I'll do this and tighten it. And I'll go down like that. And what that does, it leaves an impression in the leather of the vice grip teeth, and it looks very, very professional, very factory. Wood glue dries very fast. I would normally let it sit for about 4 or 5 minutes, but see, the way that the belt fits, we've just that little bit on the end where we've overlapped it. it shortened the belt up enough so that when we install it on our pulleys, it's going to have a little bit of stretch, which is what we want. So you just stretch it over the pulley so it has positive grip. And there we are. Installed properly. Thank you for watching.